If you were in Maurice's place, you,
me
as a
personally,
human being,
yeah.
Is there any way in hell you'd have picked Chazette?
Chazette?
I was going to say Courgette.
Chazney.
Chazzy.
From the All Saints.
Cosette instead of Eponine.
I mean, do you know what? Always on stage, when I'd seen it, you know, Eponine is the slightly dirty, definitely sexier one. I think by casting Amanda in the film, they made it... I mean, Samantha is incredibly sexy. I'm not going to say dirty, because that's just inappropriate, but such a sexy woman. But Amanda also has a phenomenal sexiness to her. So I think that it made it slightly more... But then Amanda had to try and rock a bonnet.
A bonnet
versus a kind of sexy, raggedy corset. I mean, it's pretty tricky, but, you know...
It
is. It was a tough job, I tell you.
You have to get into the mind of the character.
Exactly, yeah. No, I just had no acting required. I just sort of keep looking at them both and trying to... They kept saying chemistry, and that's not really needed. You just look in the general vicinity.
And you had to look back and forth all the time with one earpiece in.
Yeah, exactly. So. Yeah, there was actually a lot of that going, yeah.
Turn four. Were you disappointed as I was that there wasn't a sneaky Susan Boyle cameo?
I thought they could have at least. I don't know if there was an offer out. You need to speak to Cameron about that. I mean, I was convinced that would happen. I was asking Michael Ball, though. I sort of wanted him to have a cameo, but I think he was too busy.
He's too busy.
Yeah.
Too busy.
Although I would have felt a bit threatened had Michael actually been in the scene.
Yeah. You know, he's actually sitting at one of the empty tables.
Exactly.
Just going,
he's the memory of... Are you going to do it like that, are you? He's the memory of the friends. Just Michael sat on a chair. Well, they're not empty. I'm here.
I'm here.
Yeah.
Did you have a great sense of camaraderie on the set? Because it seems like... Maybe Warzone isn't fair, but it was a tough gig.
Yeah. I mean, actors always do this in interviews. Oh, God, we loved each other. It was such a wondrous group. But normally that means that, you know, one of them was on set for a day and happened to sort of meet someone in makeup. We're basically sycophants. But
sure.
That being said, this because we had 7 or 8 weeks rehearsal on this, it felt like a theatre rehearsal thing. And everyone was... Because none of us had... Firstly, we'd been through this rigorous audition process that had left us all scarred. And secondly, none of us knew what we were doing. It was, like, completely new to everyone. And so we were all trying to help each other. So I would look to Hugh and Russell for advice. If someone discovered something in the process of shooting a scene, we'd all look to each other to sort of to help each other out. And so continuing the trend of actor sycophancy, yes, it was a wondrously wonderful ensemble and great sense of camaraderie.
Oh.
And also Russell would get a marquee on a Friday and fill it with kegs of Guinness, and so we'd all get to decompress at the end of the week.
It's good for the throat.
It's great for the throat, I've heard.
Which song of the Les Mis canon gets stuck in your head the most?
Gets stuck in my head the most? Oh, that's interesting. One Day More.
One Day More.
I love it. I find it very rousing.
The one that's the earworm right now is Master of the House, which is frustrating because every time you're washing the plates, it's like...
Exactly. There's something about what was hilarious on set, though, is that you'd get the song stuck in your head all day, but then and you'd be convinced it was going to haunt you for the rest of your life. But, of course, then the next day, the next song would start. So it was a constant battle to try and wring these songs from out of your head.
Did you ever make it through the book? Honestly, tell me, did you?
Yeah, true story. I felt obliged, but it took me through like halfway through the film to do it. You know, I definitely started reading the book, feeling like I was going to be really, you know, hardworking, and of course, I only got to that. I mean, it's this big, the book, it's massive, and I got to do so about there, and then I realised I just had to skip to my bit.
Yeah, I was just thinking.
Did my bit, and then I started while we were filming going back through the whole book, and it is a brilliant book. But Victor Hugo's hilarious because he just suddenly goes off on like massive tangent about warfare, you know, and he's completely lose the plot for a while.